Hello guys, good evening and welcome. My name is Ramanohar Rai and I am the co-founder and the program director at ntprog.com and program director for all the technical courses. So today we have among us Shashank Mishra, who is going to talk about his transition from software engineer to data engineer, right? He's mostly going to talk about his own journey and you can draw inspirations from him. So this session is brought to you by ntprog, let me also introduce you ntprog for a minute. So ntprog is an edtech platform, educational platform, and it is started by alums from IIT, ISB. I am from IIT Kharagpur, but our platform is basically driven by the professionals, experienced professionals who are ready to share their experience regarding their professional life, what kind of projects they work on, what are their journeys. So that's what ntprog basically does. So after this session, please visit also our website, ntprog.com. There you can see lot of interviews. We have interviewed more than 1,000 people, 1,000 professionals, who have given their interviews on our platform. And especially our data science section is very, very strong. You can see a lot of people talking about data science projects as well as data engineering projects. So please make use of that. And recently we have, we wanted to bring the experience of professionals to fore. And we have continued that journey by also introducing the boot camps from ntprog. And one of the bootcamp that we have started is in data engineering. Probably I will explain you a bit more about our bootcamp toward the middle of the session. And without any further delay, probably I would like to start the session, and I will just introduce our expert a bit. So today expert is Shashank Mishra, who is a data engineer at Amazon. Right, and he has all the big brands behind him, right? He has worked at McKinsey, Paytm, Oprah Solutions, right? So all the big names he is scaling with himself, right? A lot of experience in this industry. He has very, very strong exposure, in working with various sectors like aviation, pharma, banking, fintech, retail, right? He has kind of covered everything that is all out there for a data engineer, right? Very good brands, lot of industries. Right. He is well versed in all the big data technologies like Hadoop, Spark Streaming, right? To name a few. So he has a lot of experience, and he has also transitioned from a software engineer to data engineer. So in today's session, we will hear about his journey. And today's session is very, very open. It's all about questions and answers, right? So he will start with his journey. But the session is an open session. We are having this today's session so that we can answer all your questions, all your doubts regarding data engineering, data science, how they are different, what are the career paths, like how can we move from data, as a software engineer to data engineer, right? How can you enter into this, a coming ecosystem of data itself, right? So welcome, Shashank. Welcome, and thanks a lot for agreeing to do the session today.
Hey, thank you, Ram. Thank you so much for this brief introduction. And good evening, everyone. This is Shashank Mishra. And as Ram said, I'm working as a data engineer at Amazon and previously worked with other big brands. So, I definitely wanted to share my journey because moving into this big data domain wasn't very straightforward, right? So, although I was studying in the tier one colleges or prestigious colleges of India, like NIT Allahabad, but still I was, I will consider myself as the dumbest student because I didn't invest my time for the exploration of the new trends in the IT industry, right? And the reason was definitely the lack of self-awareness, and I didn't get a proper path. And I was not surrounded by kind of people who can actually tell that, okay, like Shashank, being a fresher, you should look forward to this domain. This is the domain which is going like where your future would be bright in upcoming 5 years or 10 years. So definitely it was a, I would say like moving into the IT industry was the toughest part for me, but somehow I managed to land into the IT industry and I started my career as a software engineer from a service-based company, which was Opera Solutions. So Opera Solutions was working on different sectors. They were providing their solutions to different industries and different companies. And there I started as a software engineer actually. And like I was just a fresh college grad, right? And I had no idea even like how this is going to work, even the entire software development life cycle, because in my college time I was just focusing on a couple of things: data structures algorithm, any good programming language, or computer science fundamental. Apart from that, again I didn't invest my time for any new exploration like big data, machine learning, Android, iOS, anything like that. So it was definitely a new stuff for me, and somehow I managed, or I started working there, and starting 1 year I would say I was completely working on the back end, front end kind of stuffs, and like those typical web development or web service related things, right? If any of the software engineer who is working in the same domain, they can definitely relate to it. So that's how this journey started. But actually I had just one thing. I mean, I would say one quality, that I always love to interact with different people. And that's how I used to do it on the platforms like LinkedIn. There I'm highly active there. I used to interact with different people and I used to connect with different people to talk about their vision or to understand their vision. Even I used to share my stuff. That thing I was following in the Opera Solution as well. So in Opera Solution, one advantage was that there were a couple of teams who just started working on the big data solutions. Like a couple of clients came in who wanted Opera to give their services for the big data, right? So like they were working on it, and like during my free time I was just having a discussion with those colleagues, right? That hey, how did you start? Okay, what kind of use case you guys are working on, what kind of work you guys are doing, what your team does, what is this big data, everything. And that was the point when they actually guided me about the big data, that like all the terminologies, basic terminologies related to big data, whether it is distributed computation, distributed storage, or file formats, the scalability, the high availability, optimization, distributed cluster, many more things. And trust me, those words, they were really fascinating. I mean, I was just like, wow, like, dude, these guys are playing around massive gigabyte, terabyte, petabytes of data. And I was just like, wow, this is such a wonderful work. And that was the first day when I realized that it is, it can be a good career path for me. And from that day onwards, first I started exploring this big data domain by my own, that okay, like what all things I need to cover, what all skill sets I should have to be a good data engineer and to crack good product-based companies. So I invested my couple of months in order to plan a good roadmap. And after working on those roadmaps, gaining those basic skill sets, my second target was to do some hands-on, because learning and development should go hand on hand, right? You cannot do it like, okay, you know different topics, you just went through typical theoretical stuff and read some blogs or watch some YouTube videos. It is not the correct way. So that's how like I first completed those part, and second priority was that I will build something, or I will try to gain some opportunities where I can like work with those teams who are working on the big data solutions. So what I did, I just connected with different teams in my organization who are working on big data projects. I just asked them that, is there any possibility that I can shadow you guys, that so that I can gain some experience on real world problems of data engineering, right? So they all were agreed and they just pulled me in, like they wanted my 20-30% bandwidth in their project. And that's how I started working on the industrial projects of the big data. So that's how I would say it was the, if you want to relate that how actually I started. So this was, I would say, the turning point of my data engineering path. And after that, the major growth, or you can say the spike in the skill enhancement or gaining good expertise on the data engineering skill sets or building solutions around big data, that I actually got into the Paytm. Because Paytm, I was hired as a core data engineer. And when you work on a startup kind of company, right, although Paytm was well established, but in the organization, they were following the startup kind of environment. And when you work in such kind of companies, there you will get a good opportunity to work on lots of open source tech frameworks. You will have the freedom to build things by your own, and you can play around with different stuff. There you need to work in strict timelines. Development will be very rapid. You need to sometimes you need to work under pressure. And when you work in this typical situations, you definitely try to figure out best ways, best frameworks, and best skill set to accomplish these tasks as soon as possible. And that happened to me as well in the Paytm. During that 1 year tenure of mine in Paytm, I definitely gained good skill set. I worked on good problems there as well. So I would say that was the overall start of my journey in the data engineering domain.
Okay. So Shashank, if I ask you, what was your major motivation to join data engineering?
Yes.
Move into data engineering?
Yeah, that's a good question. So see, trust me, even when I was about to enter into the IT industry, since I was not very sure about my career path, my future, like how it is going to be, because there were lots of competition in the software development. You have lots of branches, and out of 10, I would say 6 to 7 people are going into the common direction, whether it is web development, iOS development, and whatever you can think of, like those common profiles. So obviously there was a lot of crowd, okay? But if you want to establish yourself in IT industry and you want to survive in a longer way, right? So definitely you should definitely target the new trends of IT technology, because they are going to overtake the market, or they will become the future of the in the upcoming years, right? So that was same methodology I was following, that after I got that sense, like talking to different people about the big data, and I did some research by my own, because I didn't took that decision very randomly that, okay, I'll choose data engineering as my career path. I had to do the research as well. What is the future scope? How companies are paying for these profiles? What are the companies who are working on the big data solution? I had to study those things as well. So I did that. I did all the aspects of moving into the big data domain, all the pros and cons, and I definitely found this profile which is best suitable for me. Trust me, like I was someone who was very much inclined towards the programming. I am someone who loves who loves to code, who loves the programming part as well, where I love building systems as well, like system designing part, where I need to combine all different components to build scalable and optimized solution or system. So definitely every computer science related fundamental, your programming concepts, your coding skills, whatever you have learned, they will be used definitely. So this is the profile in the big data domain. Trust me, if you are someone who is very much inclined towards these kind of things, you can definitely target this one, because you will get everything there. You will actually get a feel of software engineering that you are building, right?
Yeah. So Shashank, I think we got some questions on our chat box also. So one of them is like, what challenges you face and what all courses or skills you acquired when you moved to this field?
Yeah. Okay, good question. So in terms of the challenges, right, I feel myself a bit lucky in this scenario, at least because see what happens, big data domain is a kind of domain where, let's say, as a fresher, let's say in your college time, if you have done some sort of internships or if you have literally built something good by your own, right, in this big data domain or anything, then there are the possibilities that you will be shortlisted for the interviews in the good companies, right? But if you are someone, let's say you are a working professional, you have 1 or 2 years of experience, still you will be treated as an entry level fresher. And you found that, okay, this software engineering domain is not something which I am very much enjoying. Probably I want to explore more. I want to figure out something new for me. Okay, if you have that kind of thing, so first building that interest was the, I would say, the first challenge, right? Because if you are not even sure that it is going to work for you, you won't even enjoy like working on it or reading about it, anything. So first build that interest, build that confidence. Okay, whatever decision I'm going to take, I will definitely work on it and I'll prove myself. I'll get good opportunities as well. So this was the first challenge. Second challenge was to do in-depth research, because if you go over the internet and if you type crisp roadmap for data engineer, you will definitely get, you won't get anything meaningful, I would say. You will get things in a distributed manner, right? What happens, because sometimes organizations and sometimes different intellectuals, they used to combine different skill sets together. Sometimes you will see the job description where companies have mix up the roles and responsibilities of data engineer and data scientist together. It cannot happen, right? Definitely, because when you work in the well-established or managed companies, there your roles, responsibilities, and your domain would be specific, right? As a learning, if you want to learn anything, nobody would stop you. You can even do machine learning, you can explore deep learning, anything. It's up to your interest. But if I only talk about the organization perspective, your things will be specific. So first, to move into the industry, definitely you need to get the expertise on that specific set of the skill set or anything. So that's why I did a good research on specific frameworks and or you can say the crisp roadmap. I built it by my own, that what all things collectively I need to follow step by step, sequentially. Okay, so working or I would say preparing that roadmap was again the second tough challenge. And third, or the very important challenge, was that where I feel myself lucky, that getting the exposure of industrial projects. Because when you take a move, or when you are planning to take a move, if you want yourself to get shortlisted for the interviews, they would definitely expect some sort of experience from you. And to get that experience, you can only do two things. First thing, if you are like your company is working on such kind of solutions, go and interact with different managers, showcase your skill set that you know big data stuff and you want the opportunities to work on that kind of project. You will definitely get chance, I'm pretty sure, right? If your companies are working on that kind of thing. And those things you will add in your resume and it will make a good impact on recruiters, right? That, okay, this guy have worked on the good industrial projects. If like this is, you can say in your organization, if they are not working on such kind of use cases, then after getting expertise on those skill sets, you you need to build something by your own. Let's say you know Apache Spark, you know Apache Hive, you have a good understanding of NoSQL databases like Cassandra, HBase, you have a good understanding of dashboarding tools as well. So pick any real world situation. Nowadays, I would give you a best example, like COVID-19 data, right? You will get an open COVID-19 data, at least from the hospitals or the open APIs or anything. you have the tutor, right? You can get the tutor fees. And similarly, if you want to explore, you will get different real world thoughts or real world use cases. So after getting those skill sets, try to build it, work around it, and just mention it in your resume. So these three, I would say, the prime challenges I would say you will face as a fresher.
So Shashank, there's a very, very specific question, which is around, what are the courses or exact skills that you developed before you moved into data engineering?
Yeah, so first thing, trust me, I didn't go for any course. Even my time, I would say there were no as such platforms which were specifically focusing on the big data stuff or specifically data engineering stuff, right? Even so far, even I haven't seen any kind of mind-blowing platform where things are very discrete. But I think definitely Antwork, since I myself created content for Antwork, so I know these guys are definitely working on that direction to prepare very, very specific content about specific profiles, not mixing up the things together. So this is the one thing for the courses. It's up to you. I mean, if you're willing to spend some time on Googling or finding good resource on YouTube, after some efforts, you will definitely get it. And that's how even I got to know about some good YouTube channels or good blogs, which actually helped me to collect those points that, okay, what all skill sets I need to work upon. So if I specifically talk about particular skill sets to be a good data engineer, first thing is definitely you should have a good understanding of programming and data structures, algorithms, right? And advantage here, you guys might be thinking if I talk about the interviews of Amazon, Facebook, Microsoft, Google, anything. So for software engineering profile, definitely their level of programming is definitely high, advanced questions, hard level question. But here the advantage with the data engineering profile is that for the DSA, they will only touch upon till average level. Why? Because here for a data engineer, you will be working on massive scale of data and building a good design, right? So your architecting skill will play a very important role there than the DSA part. Because once that is set, definitely you have something to build, you have understanding of programming, you have a decent understanding of DSA, you will be able to do it. So that's why when you went through a interview process, they specifically focus at least on the average understanding of DSA. So this is the first thing. Second thing is definitely the very important part, understanding of databases, right? Whatever you have read in your college curriculum, like about all the basics, DDL, DML, join operations, and integrity constraints, in indexing, ER diagram, and whatever concepts you have, right? So this is the second thing. And most important, SQL writing, right? SQL will play a very, very important role in the data engineering interviews. Like your even 40% interview will be around those SQL queries, not very basic or average level SQL queries, advanced level queries, right? So this is the third thing. Fourth thing, I would say, good understanding of the big data terminologies and the good open source big data frameworks and similar kind of services which different cloud providers are also providing. So big data terminologies like distributed computation, storage and file formats, what is the structured, unstructured, semi-structured kind of data, these kind of things, and popular big data frameworks for batch processing like Hadoop, understanding it from the architecture perspective, its different functionalities, how it works, right? Its core components, everything. You need to study through, you need to study it end to end. And then the framework, which is very, very demanding in this data engineering domain, is Apache Spark. which is actually able to do the real-time processing and the batch processing. And there are other side tools, I would say side frameworks, which can make your life very, very easy. So Apache Hive is there, Apache Flume is there, Apache Scoop is there, which can solve specific use cases as well. So this is the big data ecosystem related frameworks. And in the data engineering domain, right, working on the real-time data pipelines is also very, very important, a very common use case. So you should have a good understanding of how different messaging queues, right, different frameworks which can be used as a messaging queue. For example, Apache Kafka, we have Memcached, we have Redis, right, RabbitMQ. So these kind of things, and like data warehousing, these concepts are very important. ETL pipeline designing concepts, this is again very important. And decent understanding of dashboarding as well, like how, if you have to transform data in the downstream systems, then how would you just present it on the dashboard, right? So that understanding is also important. And good deep understanding of NoSQL databases like Cassandra, HBase, MongoDB, right? Last but not the least, and very, very important in the nowadays. And why? Because everything is moving from on-premises to the cloud, right? So you should have a good understanding of the cloud part as well. So for an example, let's say you know MySQL, which is kind of a transactional database, right? You can definitely use it to build any use case. But AWS has also created similar kind of service, which is AWS RDS. So that service, what it does, it exactly works like a MySQL database, transactional database. It follows all the properties like ACID properties and all important constraints of our transactional database. So understanding those big data services in cloud is very important, right? So once you are done with those specific open source tech stack of big data, slowly or gradually start working on the big data cloud services as well. So I would say this would be the combined roadmap or a specific skill sets you need to become a data engineer.
Shashank, so what is the career path of a data engineer?
Okay, so data engineer, I would say if you are a good data engineer, after that everything is open for you, trust me. You will be someone, I mean, who like you will be having a good understanding of all the aspects, right? Even you will be closely working with the business teams as well to understand the business requirement. So even let's say after 5-10 years you are bored with the coding part, programming part, you do not want to build those systems, you want to work on your soft skills, you want to be a someone who is just getting those business requirements and dealing with clients and getting all technical aspects of it. So you can move into like a data analyst role, you can move into a BI engineer or business analyst kind of role, where you will get more opportunities to interact with the clients and less opportunities to build something, because you itself don't want to build something, or probably you just want to establish yourself as a on a managerial level where you are just managing this stuff, right? So this could be the one path for you. But let's say if you want to explore the other side or the famous side of the big data as well, like the machine learning, deep learning, building something related to artificial intelligence, and right, then you can slowly and gradually you can start working on those stuff as well. Like, so I would say in total you are moving towards data science and machine learning stuff, right? So in the data science and machine learning part, definitely your technical skill sets would be required, all right? But again, like, your analytical skill set should be very strong. You should have a good understanding of mathematical concepts and all the like theory behind or the practicals behind the statics, right? And understanding the use cases and then building those good fit models, train your models, training data, tested data, everything. So there, along with your technical skills, your analytical skills and the core mathematical concept, statistical parts and everything, those will be required, right? So that will be the another direction which you can look forward. But yeah, that's what I said. I mean, this data engineering profile will give you a good base. After that, different and multiple opportunities will be open for you, and you will be even, you will get some privilege as well. Let's say if there is a business analyst, right, with someone who started his or her career as a business analyst, definitely she or he would have like wouldn't have got the good exposure on the technical side, like building large scale systems on the scalable pipelines work or coding something or anything. Definitely they wouldn't have got it. But as a data engineer, you have this part. The only thing is now you just need to add those advanced skills, right, which will help you to move into the different direction. For example, let's say your data science related or machine learning related, or again, soft skill will play a very, very important role in the business analyst, data analyst side as well. So like this is also one advanced skill set for these domains. So you should have a good hand, or we can say you should have a good understanding of those things as well.
So as I understand, Shashank, even to get into data science, probably data engineering is one of the gateway where you will start getting some more experience, exposure to data, exposure to business before you actually move into the data science part.
Yeah. So what you can do actually, you can treat data engineers as a frontliner. In any organization, data engineers work as a frontliner because you will be someone who will bring the data from external sources or any random use case to your internal system, right? So that's why data scientists or the machine learning engineers, they don't care about how data is coming from the source to the downstream system, because in the downstream system, they will get the clean, proper or very shiny data, which is well transformed and everything. So it will be done for them. From there onwards, their actual task starts, right? Building or segregating those training data, test data, and just refactoring their coefficients or the equations which they are writing, to build that good mathematical model, right? So that's how they used to work. So that's why I'm saying every single profile has its own roles and responsibilities. If you are mixing, you won't be able to get a clear roadmap. Even if you will like keep on fighting till 10 years, you won't get a proper roadmap. But if you know the actual role and responsibilities, it will take a 10 minutes for you to get that proper and crisp roadmap for you.
So guys, probably I will just, we are getting a lot of questions from you guys. Like I have a lot of questions that you have asked. We will take on these questions in 5 minutes time. I will just take your 5 minutes to introduce our boot camp also. So as we were telling you, right, we have, ANTWOC has launched an experiential program for data engineering. Why we are calling this program as experiential program? Because this program is not going to be taught to you by academicians or career trainers, but somebody who like Shashank, right, who have been working in this field for some time, who have got the practical experience, right, so that you know they can impart this experience to you, right? So the program that we are launching is a weekend program. It's a 16-week long program with weekend live classes. We are going to have one class every Saturday, and two classes are going to be on a Sunday, right? The core part of this boot camp is of course about the data engineering, but we are also going to add a lot of professional skills into the picture, right? Because as we were hearing from Shashank, that you know, as you grow in your career, even at the beginning of your career, you will need to interact with a lot of people, with management, with data scientists, right? So you need to have a very good communication skills, presentation skills, writing skills, right? So those things will also be part of our program. Right. So this program is going to be, you know, we will having every, we have divided this whole program into 10 or 11 segments, right, which we are calling as competencies. And each segment is going to be taken by an expert who is expert in, you know, in his, in that domain. Let's say when we talk about, let's say Spark streaming, right. So somebody who has already worked on Spark streaming for some time, he's going to come and teach it to you. Right, so that he can bring up his own experiences to you guys regarding, you know, where, what are the use cases that you should encounter and what are the challenges you're going to face. Right, so every time when we take a skill, we are going to have a real life project along with it. Right, so these projects are also going to be designed by these experts, and they will mimic something that they're going to do, they're doing in their own organization. Right? So whenever you are doing this kind of project, they will be good enough, you know, so that you can put it on your GitHub repository, which can then be, you know, checked by your potential recruiters in future, right? So our idea is to make sure, you know, this is the reason why we are bringing these experts into domain, so in, you know, in, into this bootcamp, so that they can give you the real feel of how it is to, you know, work in an organization, right? So you will get, you know, hands-on experience with SQL, NoSQL databases, stream processing, distributed systems. You will bring the real world solutions, right? And you will get to know also the awesome mentors, you know, that who are going to teach you, right? With this, we are also going to bring up, you know, we are going to provide you the 100% placement assistance. We are in talk with a lot of people, a lot of companies. Right, so that by the time you are graduate, you have graduated from the program, you have a few interviews lined up. Right, so that's part of this program, the 100% placement assistance. I will just walk you through also how we have you know, organized this program. So if you see this picture, this is the whole you know, a timeline of our program. We are going to start this program with the quick revision of Pandas, you know, Python concept. But the concepts that we're going to revise again are those ones which are going to be used in your, you know, programming for data engineering, right? So that's where we are going to start. Probably we'll spend some time there. Then we'll quickly move on to the shell and advanced SQL, right? As Shashank was telling you, right? The SQL is the crux of the whole data engineering. So you need to be very good at it. So we are going to introduce the advanced SQL part here, and advanced SQL is going to be taken by the Shashank himself, right? He has designed this course himself and also designed the project part, right? This advanced SQL concept we are going to use again throughout the course, right? Even if it is when you go to the DBMS and data modeling, you're going to use a SQL or some form of SQL, Hadoop, big data development, data processing. Even throughout the course, you are going to use a SQL or SQL-like programming. So that by the time you are graduating, you have a, you know, full idea around SQL, and you have your hands dirty multiple times on SQL. Right. So one thing about this program is, you know, we expect you to know a little bit of a Python programming, so that, you know, at least this writing program is not something that you are going to struggle with. If you don't have very good idea on programming. So even if you have a you know, very good idea about the Java programming, I think that's good enough. We need you to have you know, some sense of production level programming, right? And if it is not the case, then you may have to spend some extra 1 or 2 weeks just going through the Python itself, right? So that by the time you join the course, you are at par with everyone. Right, so if after advanced SQL, we are going to look into the data modeling. Right, and this course, this bootcamp that we're launching is basically going to be on Azure, right? And the reason why we have taken the Azure as the base of this program is because that is, Azure is the platform of choice for, you know, all the Fortune 500 companies, at least for their analytical solution, right? But the concept that they're going to learn here, they can be used on on-prem or also on any platform, right? But as a you know, practical aspect, we are going to use Azure platform here, right? So we'll give you some idea about Azure also before you start your program. Then we'll move into you know, a big data and Hadoop development. We'll move into data lakes and Azure, and again, you know, data warehouse. Then the natural progression is that you're going to go into data processing and batch processing. You will move into real-time stream data processing also, you know, the Kafka you're going to use here. So these are all very, very specific skills, right? When you start from big data to, data lake, right, warehousing, they're all very, very specific skills, which some of you may have already known one of them, but you may still be lacking in the other one of it, right? And at the end of this program, we are also going to talk about the data governance. We are going to talk about the data security, right? Because as a data engineer, you are going to be a very, very important part of your company, where you will be required to take decisions with respect to these managerial aspects. So all those aspects are going to be covered here, right? So guys, we would have posted some links where you can go register yourself. Some of our counselors will come and connect with you. They will tell you much more about this course. They will give you much more detail about, and probably you can get our brochure also, right? Which will have much more description about the course, right? So that's about our Python bootcamp. Shashank, you can continue.
So definitely, guys, it is it will be really beneficial for you, because that's what I was talking about, the data engineering and all the things, right? Because finding that crisp roadmap, and let's say somehow you got the crisp roadmap, then watching 5-hour long YouTube video, and you won't be even sure that whether that guy have worked on the actual use cases or the real world industry problem or not. But here the opportunity is to learn from the industrial XP, like people who have the good exposure on the real world projects, who are working professionals and have a good experience on that particular profile. So it will be really beneficial for you if you are someone who is looking forward to move into this domain, or if you want to make your career into this domain, feel free to just go through with all the details, and for sure you will find it very, very useful for you.
So we will move into the questions now that we have received from the audience here. So there's one very interesting question, Shashank, right? So I am working, so this is from Ankur Chaudhary. I am a working professional with 2 years of experience. I am planning to pursue data engineering in future, for which I am going to do master's. I am confused between MS in data science program and MS in CS or MS in CS with specialization data science. Which one is the best for data engineering perspective?
Okay. It looks like I missed some points of his question, because that question seems like a very long. Mind repeating it again?
sure. So the question is about choice between MS in data science program and MS in computer science, or MS in computer science specialized in data science. Which one is best for the data engineering perspective?
Okay, so see, again, please don't mix up the things with the data engineering stuff, right? Because you already said MS program for the data science and machine learning, right? So see, if you are actually someone who have planned for the MS, then my suggestion would be definitely go for the data science and ML part, right? If you are going for the masters or MS from anywhere outside of India, right? So, but if you are interested actually in the only for the data engineering part, then I don't think so that MS part with the data science specifications or anything would be required. If you are someone who has done your MS with the computer science normally, right? Or if you got a good exposure on the data side somewhere during your internship or anywhere in your projects or whatever it would be, you will be able to move into this data engineering. But as a personal suggestion, if you want to take my opinion, if you're going for MS, go for the data science one.
So there's one more question. So does skills like data warehousing, data modeling are mandatory in data engineering field, or only big data knowledge is not enough?
So see, only big data knowledge is not going to help you, right? Because when it comes to take the ownership, right, you will be working on a project, right? So there definitely you need to take the ownerships as well. And when you take the ownerships, you need to work on the each and every aspect of a solution, right? You cannot think like that, okay, there will be a data analyst or business analyst who will design a data warehouse for me. They will design all the structure, they will get it, okay, what all tables should be there, what should be the facts, what should be the columns, what should be the primary keys, foreign keys, the relations between the table. Right. It doesn't happen like each and every place, right? When you take the ownership, you need to work on those aspects as well. And that's how you design a complete solution. So if you think from a complete solution, you should have a good understanding of the data warehousing part and the dashboarding part as well. Why dashboarding part? I will tell you. Let's say you are closely working with your business team, right? They wanted you to implement some solution. Let's say you did it, right? Without testing that transformed data on the dashboard, you cannot hand it over to your business team, right? Because you are even you are not sure that, okay, whatever aggregation or whatever total cost I am showing on the dashboard, it is actually correct or not. Maybe I would have done some mistakes while building that pipeline. Maybe I missed some data filter. I am getting some garbage values, right? So if you don't even know how to play around with the dashboards, creating different dashboards, how will you hand it over to the actual customers, right? So that's why to be an all-rounder and to be a complete package, you should have the good understanding of those skill sets as well.
Shashank, there is one question which I have also encountered very, very regularly is that what are people are confused between data analytics and data engineering, right? That some people are learning data science, data engineering, data analytics, right? They want to understand, right, what are the market opportunities in both areas like, right? Or is it like one is better than other? Like, what are your takes about the prospects as well as which is better, which is worse?
He's asking for a comparison between data engineering and data science.
Data science, right? Because people are generally confused, right? First of all, a lot of people don't even know the demarcation between these two, right? So even if they know the demarcation, there's always a choice: should they go for a data science or should they go for the data engineering? Which one is better with respect to career perspective?
Yes, that's a good question. Even I used to encounter a lot of questions from freshers as well. That where should I move? I mean, data science. Even I have seen people only, probably sometimes I feel it like they have made it overhyped. The data science domain, they have made it overhyped because they used to connect with building fancy stuff like AI, deep learning, those image processing stuff, deep learning and everything. They think data science is only about working on those stuff. It is not right. And trust me, based on my experience in the market, what I have seen, the profiles, like the profiles which you have in the big data domain, right? Whether I talk about the business analyst, BI engineer, data analyst, each and every profile in the big data domain, they have a good growing opportunity, good future growth in the industry, and good pay scale. You won't feel that a data science will be getting a 50 lakhs per annum and being a data engineer, you will be getting 15 or 20 lakhs per annum. No, there is a good competition between all the profiles in the big data domain, because now if you want to explore or you want to do some research, every single enterprise is trying to work on the big data solution. They don't want to keep their data in their databases or somewhere. They definitely want to utilize it, right? They definitely want to solve some purpose. And to do that, definitely you need to hire good talent who have some experience, who have a good exposure. Because see, what happens as a fresher, if I say that, okay, a fourth year student, he or she cannot get a good exposure of big data problems, because how would you able to generate 100 terabytes of data by your own? You can only get that experience in the industry. And if you have gained that experience somewhere, then definitely you are going to make some difference, or you will be highlighted, right? You will stand out from the crowd. So don't just think that what should be the ideal path for me. I always focus on one thing, your interest, right? I don't think that, okay, Shashank ne bola hai, toh hum data engineering mein chale jaate hain. But if you are someone who likes mathematics, who loves statistics, who loves building those ML things, definitely a data science career is a good fit for you. Why are you even thinking to go into the data engineering? And if it is a vice versa, then same thought about the data engineering as well. So that would be my thought. I mean, give priority to your interest first and then listen to other people.
So guys, my thoughts also. So actually what has happened in last few years, most of the companies, they have created a data science team within themselves, right? But it has come to the, you know, the everybody's knowledge, you know, that these teams are not very productive. And one of the reasons why they are not very productive is, you know, most of the companies, they don't have sufficient data with them, right? So data scientists themselves, they have ended up doing the work of a data engineer, and some team have started getting, you know, this data now. Now, actually, everybody has realized, right, that before they can start working into data modeling or anything, they need to have the data first, right? And that's why suddenly, if you see that for last 1 or 2 years, the requirement of data engineers have gone up, right? Because every team which is a data scientist, they are now going on and, you know, having at least 1 or 2 data engineers in their team. So that's why, that's also reason why this year, and if you have seen, right, there is, you know, lot of companies, lot of institutions that have been offering data scientists for, you know, that data science course for last 2-3 years. There's huge demand for Andrew NG course on Coursera, right? Because everybody is trying to become a data scientist. But what has happened in between is, you know, that something which, you know, a bulwark that is required for data science, which is a data engineering, that has missed out in the previous epoch, right? And that is now coming now, right? So that's why data engineering jobs have started picking up right now. And it has become, you know, a very, very hot trend in the market, right? So we'll move forward also, Shashank. So there's one more question. There are a few more questions, right? One of them, which is very interesting, is that, you know, which this is from Samba Kumar. I have observed some DE job descriptions mention DevOps tools like Docker and Kubernetes. Is this skills required for DE?
Yeah, good question. And this kind of job profiles or job description, you will mostly find on the career portal of startups or the mid-sized companies. Like, I'll tell you the reason why. Because see, these companies, whether, let's say, these mid-sized companies or the startups, so they are just growing, right? They, like, on their growing phase, they cannot only invest too much on the resources. So they definitely need good people who can sometimes take the ownership of other stuffs as well, right? Like building that complete thing, architecture, or even during, like they will give you the ownership to set up the things, like spin up the cluster, everything, put up the security layer and make the things very secure, and the automated deployment process, and everything should be running on a container side, right? So this thing will definitely happen. I won't say that it is a mandatory skill. Not at all. It is not a mandatory skill set for a data engineer, right? It will be a plus, definitely, because if you have learned something new for anything, let's say the deployment or let's say containers or anything, it will be treated as a plus. Not, let's say, today, probably at any particular point, or let's say you are working on a different use case, it may help you in future. So think from that perspective, right? You can say, don't treat it like a mandatory skill set required for a data engineer. That would be my thought.
So Shashank, there's one question regarding the career transition, which is from Abhilash Lanka. He's asking, can 5 years experience working as a SPET switch to data engineering role?
Okay, so means working in the QA, like quality analyst, like, or test engineer to the data engineering. Yes, I would say yes, because trust me, recently, I was mentoring one student, I would say. He was also working professional, and he was having 3 years experience in .NET, right? You can imagine .NET, very kind of old school technology, right? And he took a move from .NET developer to the data engineering. And being at, like, at least software engineering testing profile, you would have a good understanding of the latest. At least I'm saying the you will have a good understanding of Java, or maybe sometimes if you're working on Python, and you will have a good understanding of other things as well, right? You just need to put a little bit extra efforts to work on the specific skill sets required for data engineering. And again, it would be good if you can get some exposure of the industrial projects. If not, you can build something good by your own. You have experience, right? You can play around with the real world problems and convert it into a good solution, and just present it as a project in your resume, right? So that's how. 5 years experience, not a big deal to move into this data engineering.
So Shashank, there is a question from on the other side of the spectrum of work experience also, which is from Mohana. Right? What's your take on companies not taking freshers or people with less relevant experience for data engineering role? How do you handle this bottleneck?
Okay, see, it's a debatable question. I would say if you will talk to 10 people, you will get 10 perspective for it, right? So see, you will think from the candidate perspective, and companies will think from a business perspective, right? So again, let's say you are a growing startup. You are someone, let's say you started your own company, who will provide a big data solutions to different clients or different customers, right? So again, if you remember the past conversation, I focus on one point, that being a fresher, okay, you can go through with different use cases, right? You can work on dummy projects, you can gain the good expertise on those skill set, but the only thing which will be remaining, not getting the exposure of actual industrial project and huge scale of data, because you cannot generate it. That kind of exposure, definitely you will get it in the industry only, right? So, but nowadays what I have seen, like spending too much time on the LinkedIn site as well, I have seen like good people, good talented freshers, like they have worked on the like good relevant stuff, right? And definitely companies like their ideas, or they like the kind of projects they have worked on, or the kind of tech stacks they have used. So definitely they are getting opportunities. But I would say, like, mostly, at least in 70% case, 70% cases, if you are targeting well-established companies, it will be very, very challenging for you to join those firm as a fresher, because they will definitely give a priority to the folks who are having at least 1 year of experience in this big data domain, right? So that's what I'm saying. Just think from the business perspective as well. Like, if you are a company, like you need to invest too much in like on a fresher as well, right? So that's why I'm saying, like, please, no offense, it's just a debatable question. I'm just sharing the perspective of companies right in front of you, because I have heard these terms from the different startup founders, because I keep on talking to different people. So that's why, like, they used to say, like, as a fresher, let's say you are someone who is a fourth year student, and you want to join my firm as a data scientist, I need to invest a lot on you, right? I need to pass you through with the like multiple theory trainings, like 6 month trainings, or you should have a good exposure of all the industrial stuff, or the best practices to be followed you should have, right? So these kind of things would be difficult for the companies to make that investment. And from a 1 year experience or 2 years experience, they would expect that, okay, at least this guy know this thing, right? So just a little bit guidance about the use case, and he or she will be able to handle it. So that's how it works.
So this very interesting question from Kuldeep Pal. Actually, he has given a lot of questions. Probably I will go to the last one. Mm-hmm. All right. So he's asking, can I shift from D to ML or data science in future? And there's one more follow-up question for it. If you get an opportunity in Amazon in ML team, would you go for it, or will you love to work with the DE only?
I definitely love to play around the data engineering stuff, trust me, right? Because in the beginning, I told you, right, I am someone who is much more inclined towards the programming, core coding, DSA, building large scale systems, right? Playing around the architecting the things, right? And I'm really bad in the mathematics side, right? And the statics part, you can say. So I would say it's not a relevant profile for me. I can explore the things if there is a need from the exploration perspective and everything. That's, I mean, that can be done. No issues on that. But like, I love the data engineering profile very, very much. I am not going to change it at all. Probably after 10, 15 years, I might be working as a like analytical head or analytical manager somewhere, but no, I'm not going to shift my career from B to any other profile. And yes, your question, like, can I shift from B to ML or data science? Yes, like when we were talking about, when Ram asked that question, what are the paths after the data engineering? So you will be having multiple open paths, and data scientist and ML is one of them. Like, since you are really good in the technical side, you just need to put extra efforts on understanding the things related to data science, like those mathematical things, statistical, analytical part, building those models and everything, and you will be able to move it. No big deal on that.
There's one more question from him, that, you know, if I want to be a data engineer, can I go only with Python and PySpark, or should I also learn the Scala? I think a lot of people have gotten technical Scala also.
Yeah, any of these, like, right? So even when you will apply for the interviews, you will always see three things: Python / Java / Scala, right? For the data engineers, you will definitely see these three things, right? So language is not a barrier there. Even your manager even won't ask you that, hey Shashank, you need to implement this pipeline using PySpark and Python only. He will just leave everything on you. The way you want to implement, feel free to do it, right? So if you have worked on the like Spark using Scala, fair enough, like, you are good to go. No blockers on that.
Okay. I think Shashank, we have I think one more question has come up. So the question is, there's one person who has done his BCA. Mm-hmm. Can he get a job in data engineering without doing the MCA?
Okay, let me just check. Good. Okay, after BCA, can I get job in data engineering domain, or I should go for MCA? After BCA, definitely it is going to be hard for you, since I am also from MCA background. I completed my MCA and then software engineering and then data engineering part. So to get very, very good opportunities in the IT industry, I would definitely recommend you to go for the MCA. And please, for God's sake, don't put your money to do MCA from the private colleges. No, not at all. Just put a little bit extra effort. First, there are national level exams which can help you to crack the prestigious colleges of India, like good curriculum on MCA, good placement, right? So prepare for that. I have also cracked NIMCET and was able to join NIT Allahabad because of that. So, like, from an MCA background guy, I would like, I can connect with you. So my best recommendation would be for you that.
Okay. There is one question from Lakshya, right? So he wants to know the good resources to learn system design for data engineering.
So there is no specific concept about like system design specific for the data engineers. See, system designing is something like...
Shashank, we lost you.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah, we just lost last few seconds. That's it.
Okay. Yeah, so see, there is nothing very, very much specific very, very much specific to like system design for data engineering. It is, you should treat it like a system designing part, right? For what I would say, like, let's say you want to build a system. So think from the pipeline perspective, right? Just, and like what you can do, you can think of any hypothetical situation. Let's say you have an Amazon e-commerce platform. There are clicks happening. They might be storing those clicks data somewhere else, right? Just treat it like a MySQL, NoSQL, or even cloud storage or anything, okay? And then think that, okay, if I need to build some tool, or sorry, I need to build some dashboard on top of it, okay? then what could be the possible structures I can use to build that pipeline scalable? Because see, Amazon also runs campaign for their like Holi sales, Diwali sales, or different random sales, right? And when these sales will come up, definitely you will get a huge spike in your data. So scalability comes into the picture. So while building your pipeline, you will also think for that perspective that how can I build my pipeline in such a way that it is very, very much scalable. So when you will design that hypothetical situation or hypothetical case about building that pipeline, then meanwhile, you will also start working on building that design, that what all should components will be there. Because for everything, you will get 2-3 alternatives. Now you need to do the benchmarking. Which one should I use for like what kind of use case? So like that is the thing for like system designing related to the data engineering. There is no very, very much specific term system design for data engineering.
I think probably we can close our session for today, Shashank. We have all the cost of 10 minutes over the time stipulated for it. I think you also have had a very busy day. Thanks again a lot, Shashank. I think you answered a lot of questions very well here, and I am very sure everybody who has attended this session would benefit out of it. Thanks a lot again, Shashank. And guys, please give a big hand to Shashank for taking some time to take this session today.
Yeah, thank you so much, Ram, for having me again here. And it's always seems like a pleasure to interact with different people and answering those questions. I hope whatever we discussed, it would help you guys. And I will see you guys again. And don't forget to check out the upcoming bootcamp. It is going to be a fun and full of learning session. So hope to you guys will be checking that out, and I would love to see a couple of folks there as well.
You can not only check on our bootcamp, but we have hosted a lot of interviews also from experts like Shashank, right, who have talked about their own experience, what they have done, right? Probably you will get much more idea also about this field. Hope to see you all in the bootcamp itself. We keep on running some master classes also on a weekly basis, right? So go, please check on the AntTalk events page also. There you will get to know also about our upcoming master classes, right? So have a good evening. Good night, guys. Bye bye, Shashank.
I was on mute. Bye bye, everyone. Bye bye.